Hey guys, what's up? My name is Sky Webb and I'm here to talk about a true crime story that I cannot get off my mind. But before I get started, I just want to put out a little disclaimer that I mean no harm to any of the victims or the victims' families. And I wish everyone who was hurt within this story the utmost peace and solace, ever in rest or in recovery. With that out of the way, happy True Crime Thursday. We are so close to Christmas. It's only a week away. I hope you guys are getting into the spirit and enjoying it as much as I am. I've got a hat on today, but it is very tight and I feel like it makes my hair look like a crazy wig, but it's cute though. Today we're looking into the bizarre out of the blue case of the Lawson family murders. The Lawson family consisted of mum and dad, Charles Lawson and Fanny Lawson, and they got married in 1911. And together they had 8 kids, but unfortunately one of the kids when they were younger, they died due to an illness. But the other 7 kids grew up happy and healthy, and they were very loved by their parents. Charles had grown up with a family of tobacco farmers, and they never really had a lot of money, but they were very good at saving it. And by 1927, they had enough money to actually buy a tobacco farm of their own. And so Charles worked and ran this family tobacco farm. So on Christmas Day, 1929, Charles told his family that he had a big surprise for them for Christmas. And so they were a working class family. They never had a whole lot of money. They never really got to do anything that was like super expensive or lavish or, you know, like a treat. And so he had organized for them to go and get a professional portrait taken of the family. And they were actually quite excited for this because, as I said, they never really got to do things like this. And this was like a treat to them. This was really like a lavish thing to go out and do on Christmas. And so he actually took them to the shops first and bought all of the kids new clothes, which the girls were super excited about. So the kids consisted of 17-year-old Marie, 16-year-old Arthur, 12-year-old Carrie, 7-year-old Maybelle, 4-year-old James, 2-year-old Raymond, and only 4-month-old Mary Lou. Mary Lou who? It's so Christmassy. So they went and got all the new clothes, they dressed in their Sunday best, and then they went and got this portrait taken. And this photo would be the last photo ever of this family. And they died on the same day. So it is super eerie to look at it and like, it's so creepy to me. Once they got home after taking this portrait, Charles asked Arthur to go and run some errands for him. Then Carrie and Maybelle, they decided that they wanted to go and visit their uncle and auntie, seeing as it was Christmas Day, they wanted to go and hang out with them. And so they set off walking because they didn't live very far away. Across the farm. As they were walking past the tobacco barn, a man came out from behind the barn and shot them with the shotgun. And it was Charles. It was their own dad who shot them and killed them. He actually ran over to them after shooting them and bludgeoned them to assure that they were really dead. He actually carried their bodies and hid them in the tobacco barn before going back towards the house, and he came across his wife Franny, who was sitting on the porch, and he shot her. Marie was inside the house when her mother was shot, and so she heard the gun and she screamed and she tried to run, but by the time she like tried to take off, Charles had already entered the house and he shot her as well. So then both Raymond and James, who were only 4 and 2 years old, they were freaking out, but they had the sense not to like cry or scream or anything. They were just trying to hide. That's all they were trying to do, just hide. But Charles searched the entire house and unfortunately he found them and he shot them as well. I can't even begin to imagine the fear that would be going through a 4-year-old's head as their dad is running around the house with a gun. Like, oh my God, like that's someone you love and trust and what the fuck? Like oh my God, I just can't even fathom the fear that those two little kids would have been fucking feeling. And then Charles went and found Mary Lou and he bludgeoned her to death. He also went out and bludgeoned Fanny as well to assure she was dead too. He actually positioned all of his family's bodies in a certain way so that their arms were crossed over their chest and so their heads were positioned on rocks. And we're not entirely sure, you know, why he did that. And then he retreated to the nearby woods. And at this point, 16-year-old Arthur got home to find his entire family dead, except for his dad, where he didn't know where his dad was. And it's still unclear as to why Charles saved Arthur. Like, he purposely sent Arthur out to go and run errands when he decided to kill the entire family. So it really makes you wonder why. Like, what did Arthur do to get out of that, and why didn't he have that same like care for any of his other children, especially the younger ones, like the baby? Like, it's weird. When Arthur arrived, the neighbors and the police had already gotten there, and they all met at this crime scene. And that is when they heard a final gunshot coming from the woods. So Arthur actually ran there, and he arrived first to find his father's dead body after he had just shot himself in the head. The police determined that Charles had paced back and forth around this tree for quite some time. There was a lot of footprints until finally shooting himself and committing suicide. But nobody could determine the motive for these murders. It literally makes no sense. There was no reason to do it, or no reason that we thought at the time. Nothing has ever been like specifically said this is the reason. He didn't leave any clue as to why he might have done it. Again, no clue as to why he might have left Arthur out of it. And it wasn't actually until years later that rumors between the aunts and the cousins and the family and even friends started circulating that Marie had an incestuous relationship with her dad, Charles. And one of her close friends had, you know, gossiped with an aunt that she had fallen pregnant with her dad's child. It's unclear, even in the rumors, whether or not this relationship was like consensual. Obviously she was underage, so either way it's not consensual and it's incestuous, but it's still unclear whether or not she, you know, was a happy member of this relationship, or whether it's something he imposed on her. And there's also no like hard proof to prove that this was ever a thing or that she was ever pregnant. There was no like autopsy done at the time that proved that she was pregnant. It's all just like hearsay and gossip and whispers. But these whispers originated from people who were very close to the family, like the aunts and the cousins and the best friend. So a lot of people do believe that there was something going on there. Whether or not that had anything to do with the murders, or whether or not she was actually pregnant, we don't know, they don't know, and we'll never fucking know. This case is absolutely bizarre and leaves us with no closure, which I absolutely fucking hate, but I couldn't help myself but to tell this story because it is so creepy and bizarre, and that photograph just is so, like, it gives me the heebie-jeebies, and I just really wanted to share that. And also it's Christmas themed, unfortunately. But that is the Christmas murders of the Lawson family. Please let me know what you think about this one down in the comments. I would love to know what you think the motive might have been, whether you think maybe there was an incestuous thing going on. Do you think that that's like an appropriate response to that scenario? Why do you think that he just let Arthur go? Like, why? What reason would there be to let 16-year-old Arthur go, but everyone else must die? It makes no sense to me. Let me know what you think in the comments down below, or you can head over to my social medias, which are all linked in the description. I would love to hear your opinions on this. Be sure to give this video a big thumbs up if you feel like it. I would really appreciate it. And be sure to subscribe so that you can see all my new videos. I post every single Thursday all about true crime, and I would love to have you be a part of it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you're staying safe out there. Don't trust your parents, don't do what they tell you to do, and most importantly, if your dad is happy to take a photo, take that as a sign. That is sus as fuck. Dads don't take photos. Thank you for watching, stay safe, bye! So the kids incested? Marie was inside the house when her mother was shot, and she heard this shot.